Here we have a Merrell High Fidelity tube amplifier. Merrell Electronic. Actually, it says electronics. Not sure if you can see that down there or not. As you can see, I have it hooked up right now. Let me adjust the volume knob. Sounds good. If you look on the side here, it does have some marks on it. And on the top, you could either repaint the top piece to match or paint it another color, which would look cool also. I've seen a lot of them painted black. And here we got the other side. The top on this has never had the screws ever installed. So all I have to do is just grab it and it pulls right off. So now we can see the tube amp. You can see that when they're glowing. The other ones you really can't see glowing. I will have the what tubes are actually in here on the listing. But right here's the loudness control again, which is the volume. I'm gonna turn up for once, but it may sound distorted on your side, but I'm not gonna turn up to the point where it sounds distorted on my side. It's a very clean sounding amplifier.
That make me sick. I know, I feel you. That's why we gotta stick together.
It has inputs for mag phonograph tape, crystal phonograph, tuner, this is mic auxiliary. It's a mono amp, like I said. But I have it hooked up to the two inputs right now. I have the left and right hooked up to two different inputs, I can switch it like that. That turns it to mic input, which kills the sound. And after I pull the power cord out, as you can hear, the sound starts to fade away when it's unplugged. And whenever I plug it back in, you see the sound starts to come back as the tubes charge themselves up. I'll take multiple pictures of this whenever I get ready to list it. See, it has four inputs, it has speaker inputs, hookups. I'm using the two outer hookups and I get sound coming out the speakers. And there's a plug in the back, which if you have another one of these amplifiers, you can use one for each side, like to make like into like a stereo. It takes two mono blocks to make a stereo block. Now I am using an 8-ohm speaker, and I believe most of these call for 4-ohm speakers for tube amplifiers. So So I'm probably not getting the full power output from using an 8 ohm speaker on a 4 ohm amplifier. I'd like to thank you for looking, and happy bidding.